Good afternoon and welcome to Eye on Sheridan News. I'm Mike Rye.
And I'm Claire Brassard. Today, details on an Ontario couple charged with first-degree murder.
Evan Morrison gets the scoop on a new French high school being built right behind Sheridan.
And we'll tell you why Sheridan is being noticed by Facebook.
But first, like many Sheridan students, you may be gearing up for an internship position, and you might also be a little bit fuzzy on what to expect. Well, our reporter Kabir Rathor Bagheria has some important things you need to know.
Internships aren't just about getting coffee. They offer students the chance to experience what life is like in the workplace of their chosen industry. But here at Sheridan, the word internship can be used to describe a number of things.
We use the word internship to describe a degree co-op experience. And in a very controversial way, we use internship to describe unpaid postgraduate work experiences.
But some internships leave much to be desired.
My experience was not very good. I didn't learn anything about my industry other than what I learned in school.
The Ontario Ministry of Labour has specific criteria to make sure that internships are conducted ethically. This includes that the internship is a benefit to the intern and that it doesn't replace a paid position.
Chantel uses her experience with internships in her new salon, Forever Jack. Her interns won't be doing anything that would violate the Ontario Ministry of Labour, but they still learn important skills.
When I take on interns, I obviously can't have them do everything because they're not fully done their course. In the spa industry, that's a little bit different. But I do find them things to do that doesn't only help me, but also helps them.
It's always a good idea to do your research before you make a commitment, just to make sure you know exactly what you're getting into.
Internships offer great opportunities to learn and grow in areas that you like, but make sure to select an internship that's right for you. For Eye on Sheridan, I'm Kabir Rathor Bagheria.
The York University and Sheridan College joint design program has caught the attention of Facebook. The social networking juggernaut is recruiting students to work on its site. A Facebook team is at York University's Department of Design looking for a Canadian crew to help improve the look of Facebook. The panel will choose the best of the best next Monday.
Dufferin County has declared a state of emergency because of the weather. The area was hit hard with strong winds and blowing snow, which has created hazardous driving conditions. OPP officers have been involved in several weather-related incidents. Motorists are being urged to slow down and pass to the left when they see a vehicle on the side of the road. After spending most of January under extreme weather conditions, it looks like southern Ontario is finally escaping the deep freeze. Although it started off brutally cold today, an extreme cold alert has just been lifted and temperatures will be returning to seasonal territory. But there's a price to pay for those warmer temperatures. More snow is on the way. We'll have your full 5-day forecast later in the show.
Several cargo ships are stuck in ice on the Great Lakes. The Canadian Coast Guard says its icebreaker has been working all month to keep a channel open. The hardest hit region is the western basin of Lake Erie. It's the largest cover of ice on the Great Lakes in 20 years. About six people were taken to hospital this morning after two dozen vehicles were involved in pileups near the 401 in Napanee. Snow squalls were battering the area at the time of the crash, making road conditions slippery and impairing visibility. The 401 is still shut down in both directions.
A 39-year-old man is charged with child abandonment after a toddler was left unattended inside a parked car in these freezing cold temperatures. York police say the 2-year-old girl was left in the car outside a Costco parking lot in Markham for about 40 minutes last night. Luckily, she was dressed warmly and was unharmed. The father is scheduled to appear in court on February 26th. A man is in life-threatening condition after he was shot in the head in Etobicoke early this morning. The victim was found unconscious on the ground after a gunshot was heard outside a housing complex on Waterton Road. Witnesses say they saw two males running away from the crime scene. Police say the victim was shot after a dispute with the two males. Investigators are now reviewing surveillance footage for clues.
31-year-old Chiheb Ezrir, one of the two men charged in the alleged Via Rail terror plot, went on a rant in court today. He claims that he was strip searched and was forced to show his sex. Ezrir continued to say he refused to be judged by the criminal code because it was created by humans, not God, and is therefore imperfect.
An Ontario couple charged with killing the woman's ex-husband and his mother will appear in a Halifax court today. Caleb Harrison was found dead last August in a home in Mississauga. the same home where his mother was found dead in 2010. Investigators determined that both died from asphyxiation. Police say they also have reopened the investigation into the father's death in 2009. Melissa Merritt and Christopher Fattore were arrested on Tuesday in Nova Scotia and will be taken back to Ontario to face first-degree murder charges.
A 17-year-old girl in Ottawa has been found guilty of running a prostitution ring. She was convicted on a number of charges, including human trafficking, making child pornography, sex assault, child luring, uttering threats and unlawful confinement, and sentenced to a maximum of 3 years in custody. Victims gave horrific accounts of what they were forced to do.
Quebec officials have now confirmed 17 people are dead and 15 still missing after a blaze at a Quebec seniors' home. Weather has been the biggest obstacle for fire crews who need to take breaks in order to warm up from the cold. Provincial police say they will not stop until all 32 people have been found. A major fire has destroyed four businesses in Niagara Falls. It started just after midnight on Victoria Avenue near Clifton Hill. A tattoo parlor, a cigar and souvenir shop, and a clothing store were destroyed. The cost of the damage is estimated to be around $500,000. No injuries have been reported.
Another heated debate at Toronto City Hall as Mayor Rob Ford blows a gasket over the 2014 budget. Ford is introducing a budget which he claims will result in $60 million in savings. He's already said he can't support a budget with more than a 1.75% property tax hike. The debate over the budget is expected to last throughout today's meeting and will likely be pushed over into tomorrow. Protesters inside City Hall were demanding no cuts to housing stabilization funds. And it looks like Sheridan will be getting some new neighbors. A French high school is being built right in Sheridan's backyard. Eye on Sheridan's Evan Morrison has the story.
Changes in the air in the McCraney and Sixth Line area as planning for a new French high school is underway. It is set to be built right behind Sheridan's Athletic Center.
It's proposed to be located on McCraney Street East, and it will be 300 to 500 students in size at the full build-out. It will be 2 to 3 stories in height.
Planning and rezoning of the township's property has been approved, but there are still several more stages to go before development can begin.
In terms of next steps, if council approves the zoning bylaw amendment application, then the applicant, being the school board, would be required to submit a site plan approval application.
The community is voicing concerns about putting a new school so close to the existing White Oaks High School. There are also traffic concerns for residents living in the area. Some say the additional students will mean a lot of cars and buses in the area. Mark Grant is a counselor for the city and a resident who lives right in the development area on McCraney.
I all feel like that this is a bad location for a school, and I absolutely agree with that. The problem that I have as a counselor is that I completely understand that these kids need a place to learn.
Planning for the project is still far from complete. With construction scheduled to begin within the next year, residents of Oakville could start to be seeing some big changes. Reporting from Town Hall, for Eye on Sheridan, I'm Evan Morrison.
Ontario pork farmers are warning that a deadly pig virus could cost the pork industry millions if it spreads. The group is encouraging farmers to increase biosecurity to contain the pathogen, which is transmitted through manure. Premier Kathleen Wynne says new funding in the amount of $2 million will be available to help increase safety on farms.
Drivers over 80 will no longer need to complete a written knowledge test. Beginning in April, the new exam for seniors will include a vision test, a driver record review, an in-class group education session, and two screening exercises. Ontario drivers over 80 must renew their driver's license every 2 years. Officials say the new program will take around 90 minutes, less than half the time of the current tests.
Coming up, details on the Justin Trudeau kicking senators from the Liberal caucus.
The latest in the Amanda Knox trial. Stay with us. Welcome back. In a surprising move today, Liberal leader Justin Trudeau removed all 32 Liberal senators from caucus. Trudeau says they will all sit as independents and there is now no such thing as a Liberal senator. His decision will see some longtime Liberals and party operators booted from the party. Veterans Affairs Minister Julian Fantino rejected the pleas of ex-soldiers to stop the rapidly approaching closure of 8 regional offices that serve vets. The group met with senior conservatives and later confronted Fantino for not attending. A war veteran said he feels betrayed by a government that's making veterans beg for help.
Foreign Affairs Minister John Baird has disposed of all of his English-only business cards. This comes almost 6 months after being ordered to do so by Graham Fraser, the Federal Commissioner of Official Languages. The set of unilingual cards were embossed with gold ink, which is another violation of government rules. They cost taxpayers about $425, whereas the new bilingual cards cost just under $200. A Canadian journalist is heading to trial. Mohamed Fahmy, who has been held in Cairo in a Cairo prison for the past month, faces charges of joining a terrorist group and spreading false news that endangered national security. 18 other journalists were also charged. It's the first time authorities have put reporters on trial for terror-related charges. Nova Scotians can now get their alcohol to go. Effective today, bars have the authority to sell beers made in-house as long as the patron leaves right after the purchase and maintains the seal. 1.8 and 2-liter bottles will be sold. Sales for off-site consumption must stop by 10 p.m.
Ukraine's parliament debated proposals today that would give amnesty to those arrested during weeks of protest. But the opposition says some of the conditions attached to the agreement are unacceptable. 2 amnesty proposals were up for a parliamentary vote, one of which states that amnesty would be granted to the protesters arrested only if demonstrators leave government buildings they're currently occupying in western Ukraine. The opposition leader says protesters will not agree to leave the buildings, and that condition has to be dropped. Libya's interior minister survived an assassination attempt this morning in Tripoli. An unidentified gunman targeted Al-Sadiq Abdel Karim while he was driving to work. He escaped with no injuries.
40 years ago, world-renowned theoretical physicist Stephen Hawking first described the existence of black holes in our universe. Now he's contradicting part of his theory and calling it a blunder. Hawking says the parameters around a black hole aren't as defined as he originally thought. This revelation is causing chaos in the science world because so much research is based on his original mathematical models.
Angry Birds creator Rovio Entertainment announced the game's homepage was hacked early this morning. It happened 2 days after documents leaked by Edward Snowden said NSA and British spies had access to customers' personal information through a host of smartphone apps, including Angry Birds. A Rovio spokeswoman says the hacking lasted a few minutes, but no customer information was at risk. Edward Snowden, the former NSA contractor who blew the whistle on U.S. government surveillance programs, has been nominated for a Nobel Peace Prize. The nomination comes from 2 Norwegian politicians. They say changes to the U.S. government's privacy policies following Snowden's information leak have contributed to a more stable world order. Snowden is now considered a fugitive by the American government and is seeking asylum in Russia.
Worldwide reaction after President Obama gave his 6th State of the Union address, making pledges on minimum wage and health care, among other promised improvements.
Say yes. Give America a raise.
As Obama stood in the House of Representatives chamber, he declared his independence from Congress. The president said he'd go around Congress, if necessary, and issue an executive order to increase minimum wage. He also said he'd use his power to improve health care. Activists are worried it will only give the Democratic president and the Republicans yet another reason to butt heads. U.S. Republican Congressman Michael Grimm has some unwanted media attention after he threatened to throw a reporter off of a balcony following the State of Union address. The reporter, Michael Scotto of New York News One, was trying to get Grimm to make a statement on allegations surrounding the politician's campaign spending, but it didn't go as planned.
Back to you.
Why? Let me be clear to you. You have to do that to me again. I'll tell you what.
Grimm refuses to apologize, saying he's not the first to tell a reporter off, nor will he be the last.
Amanda Knox is in Seattle as an Italian jury debates a verdict in her third trial for the murder of 21-year-old Meredith Kircher. The first two trials produced flip-flop verdicts of guilty, then innocent for Knox and her boyfriend Rafael Celestito. A guilty verdict would need to be confirmed by Italy's Supreme Court, which could take up to a year.
Officials from the U.S. Centers for Disease Control and Prevention boarded a cruise ship to investigate an illness. More than 600 passengers fell ill with severe vomiting and diarrhea on board the Explorer of the Seas. The symptoms are believed to be consistent with that of the norovirus. Snow and ice have paralyzed southern U.S. as a winter storm continues to cause havoc. In Georgia, many students had to wake up in their classrooms this morning after slick road conditions forced the schools to cancel buses last night. With more than 900 accidents reported, some desperate commuters abandoned their cars to seek shelter. Georgia state officials are asking people to stay off the roads.
After the break, Nathaniel Taylor brings the action to you with sports.
And Kanye West is out of pocket for a lot of money. How much money? Selena Singh has that story and more in entertainment right after this. Welcome back. The Leafs were in action last night. Did you see the game, Claire?
I did not, but I know someone who did. Let's throw it over to Nathaniel for sports.
Thanks, guys. The Maple Leafs continued their winning ways last night against the Tampa Bay Lightning. We will pick it up in the second. Kadri brings the puck in, shoots it off a stick, and past Ben Bishop. It is 1-0 Leafs. Minutes later, Kadri's at it again. He takes the pass from Lupul, makes a nifty move for his second of the night. 2-0 Buds. But the Lightning answer some nice pass and gets the puck to Matt Carl, and he pots it. Leafs' lead is now cut to 1. In the third, game tied at 2, and then this happened.
Nice time among forwards. Kessel gets the puck in front. They score! No, it hit the post, they say. Waved off, and Van Riemsdyk thought that puck was in the net.
The call was reviewed and overturned. The goal counts, and that is how it would end. The Leafs win 3-2. A Canadian Olympian is undergoing surgery. Mayelle Ricker, the reigning female world champion snowboarder, injured her wrist yesterday while training in Aspen. Canada Snowboard is expected to provide more information following her surgery. And the Toronto Argonauts have released backup quarterback Zach Collaros. Collaros had a 5-2 record after replacing injured starter Ricky Ray last season. His strong play guided the Argos to a division title and playoff spot. Major League Baseball has approved a protective hat for pitchers in an effort to protect them from line drives to the head. The hat will be available for testing during spring training on a voluntary basis. Safety plates are sewn into the hat and custom fit for each player. They provide protection to the forehead, temple, and side of the head. Blue Jays pitcher Jay Happ missed 77 games last season after being hit in the head by a line drive. Hockey features many players who have their own pregame rituals. Our reporter Andrew Osman visited the Oakville Blades to discuss their superstitions.
Hockey players are very dedicated athletes. They train hard and practice hard. And a big thing for some players are superstitions.
Well, I think a superstition is just something that, you know, you get into a routine and you start doing something and you just, it works for you, right? So you go with it, and when it stops working, you change it.
To me, a superstition is kind of a ritual that someone does. It's the same ritual for every game usually. Some guys even do it before practice. For me personally, it's nothing too big, but I do think that they're still important, and if something comes in the way of your superstition, then your performance can be affected.
All types of athletes are known for their superstitions. Hockey players have really unique quirks, and the Oakville Blades are no exception.
Every game day I have to go to Swiss Chalet and get the chicken on the Kaiser and a salad, and then I have to have a nap right after, and then go to the rink about 5 o'clock. And then warm-ups on the ice, I have to do the same stuff, like warm up my hands, my feet, I have to do a certain stick handling.
When I'm putting on my stuff, I put my left skate on before my right, and then I lace up my left skate, and then I tie my right skate, and then tie my left skate.
I'm always the first guy on the ice for games, and I usually lead off any drill and warm-up, because that's just, you know, I started that at the start of the season, and it's worked.
Starting as young as 7 years old, these players develop their own unique superstitions and carry them throughout their entire hockey careers. For Ion Sheridan, I'm Andrew Osmond.
That is it for sports. Now over to Selena for entertainment.
Rapper Kanye West has come to an agreement with the 18-year-old victim he assaulted a few weeks ago. The man who allegedly yelled racist slurs at Kim Kardashian has been awarded $250,000. So I guess another good way to make money in Hollywood is, well, getting punched in the face by a celebrity. Hugh Grant is also making headlines, and it's not because he made a new movie. The actor's been named the father of 16-month-old baby boy who was re-registered in December with Grant's full name. Now here's where the story gets crazy. Grant's girlfriend, Ting Lan Hong, gave birth to Grant's third child just 3 months later, which means that the two were pregnant at the same time. The mother of the boy is believed to be Swedish TV producer Anna Elisabeth Eberstein. It's reported that Hugh Grant has ended relationships with both women. Airing tonight on MTV is Miley Cyrus's Unplugged special, which features the queen of controversy, Madonna. It's been 10 years since the legendary performance with Madonna and Britney Spears, and rumor has it the pair finished the performance with a good old-fashioned booty slap. Sheridan's always been known for advancing and innovating their programs. Find out what's next for students in the musical theater program. Our reporter Andrea Hudgens has the scoop.
These third-year students are rehearsing Sheridan Theater's February production, Dirty Rotten Scoundrels. They are part of the first class to be graduating with a degree.
This is the most acclaimed musical theater program in all of Canada. And it's the only one that is a degree program, and I wanted a degree in my field, so that's why I came here.
Sheridan Theatre continues to stride forward with its musical theater program, but it wasn't an easy transition.
Next year, we're going to be graduating our first class from the new degree program. That, for me, will be an event. Then it took about 5 years of preparing a tome of information to submit to the government to get approval for a degree program. I'm very proud of this graduating class. The class that you're seeing behind me right now is the first class to go through this four-year program. They're in their third year right now.
Sheridan has always been a dream school for me in that my parents are both professional trumpet players, so I grew up watching shows at the Stratford Festival. And a huge amount of the company there is from Sheridan, and the amount of alumni that's produced at Sheridan is just absolutely spectacular and remarkable. So I think to be here now and with this amazing group of my peers is just a blessing, really. So
here at Theatre Sheridan, the third years will be performing Dirty Rotten Scoundrels from February 11th to the 23rd. For Eye on Sheridan, I'm Andrew Hodgins.
Lions, tigers, bears, oh my! This year's Oscars will honor the all-time classic, Wizard of Oz. Although the movie was nominated for 6 Academy Awards in 1939, the beloved film shocked many when it didn't win Best Film. The Oscars will pay a tribute to the movie as it celebrates its 75th birthday. Tonight, join Canadian superstars Mia Martina and Masari as they perform live at the Sheridan Davis campus. It's a white sensation party, so the first 200 people to get through the doors gets a glow stick. Doors open at 8 o'clock, and don't forget to wear white. It's an event you won't want to miss. On this week's Entertainment Roundup, don't miss Bruno Mars and the Red Hot Chili Peppers as they rock the stage at the Super Bowl this Sunday. Today, Oprah Winfrey celebrates her 60th birthday. Happy birthday, Oprah! The Writers Guild Awards are on Saturday, and comedian Brad Garrett is expected to host this year's event. Last but not least, the petition to deport Justin Bieber back to Canada has been signed by 100,000 Americans and is now waiting for the response from the White House. That's all for your entertainment news today. Back to the desk.
Thanks, Selena. Well, we're not even halfway through this winter, and it's been a cold one so far, to say the least. Our weather specialist, Hutch Hoffman, will tell us what to expect in the days to come, right after this.
Well, I'm sure by now everyone is wondering just when this cold weather is going to give us a break already.
Our weather reporter, Hutch Hoffman, is standing in the cold right now, poor guy. Let's hope he has some good news for us. Hutch?
Thanks, guys. It's absolutely freezing out here today, with Environment Canada releasing yet another cold weather alert for Toronto. But we should be receiving some relief from these cold temperatures soon. Today, it's been a chilly one with a high of minus 10 and a low of minus 16 and a wind chill that makes it feel a little closer to minus 30. Now it's time for your 5-day forecast. Thursday, we'll have cloudy periods with a high of minus 4 and a low of minus 12. There's a 12% chance of precipitation, and yes, that means more snow. Friday will have scattered flurries with a high of -1 and a low of -4, and yes, probably more snow. Getting a little warmer Saturday with a high of 2 and a low of -4, and there's a 70% chance of mixed precipitation. Sunday is cooling down a little bit with cloudy periods with a high of -5 and a low of -10 and a 20% chance of rain. Well, that's all for your weather. I hope you've all been nice and warm today. Now back to the desk.
Thanks, Hutch, and thanks for watching the latest in news today. I'm Mike Rye.
And I'm Claire Broussard. Thanks for joining us. Have a good afternoon.